Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Coinsilium Group CEO Eddy Travia, as well as Chief Financial Officer Ben Proffitt. Eddy, Ben, good to have you on the program today. So you're up with results this week. I'm going to start with you, Ben. Give us a broad overview of your performance last year.
Sure. Well, I think the story of these accounts is really one of recovery from what was a pretty horrible year in 2022. Last year, we had to book about £1.3 million in impairments against our cryptocurrency reserve holdings, which pushed the overall loss for the year to £2 million. So that was obviously pretty tough for us. Obviously, over the course of 2023, we've seen recovery in crypto prices. Bitcoin ended the year around $42,000 or thereabouts. So that's allowed us to book a gain this year of around £200,000. Now, obviously, these assets have continued to appreciate over the course of 2024. So there's a substantial amount of value in these reserves that we hold that aren't actually reported on the accounts because they're focused on 2023 as the year end. Last year, we also had to book some impairments on our investments in various crypto projects, which was, again, driven by the downturn in broader industry sentiment, following the crypto pricing crash. Now, this year, obviously, with the recovery, we've reported much steadier figures on the values of these investments, which has been driven by a revival of the underlying projects and an improvement in their prospect for value creation. So overall, we reported a £660,000 loss for the year compared with last year, which was a £2 million loss. And I think that demonstrates quite clearly the emergence from the downturn that the company has gone through, coupled with our focus on constraining costs all the time, running a very lean ship, and preserving our assets and our resources wherever possible. Now, we ended the year with around £300,000 in cash and around £500,000 in crypto reserves. But post-year end, we bolstered further this cash position with a raising that we undertook in March 2024. Which was for just under £500,000, and in which the directors elected to participate as a further demonstration of their support and their confidence in the company and its prospects. So when you take all these numbers together and you consider the ongoing growth and the value of our crypto reserves over the course of 2024, I think you can see that from a resource perspective, we're very robustly positioned to capitalize on the revival in the markets and continue to support our clients and our investments as they look to continue to develop their projects over the next phase.
Eddy, financials aside, you were also very busy operationally in 2023. So you acquired Web3 advisory services business, the Web3 advisory services business of Tokenomi. And you've also had collaborations with other Web3 projects. Could you touch on those for us, please? And where you're going with your Web3 business?
Yes, you're right. So, these cycles work in a way that when the crypto prices are, a bit depressed, the companies tend to build, that's how the industry sees it. And so we also took advantage of, kind of a quieter pace in the crypto space so that we can work on our long-term strategy. So we have acquired an advisory service business, and which is starting to bear its fruits with new advisory clients that have been announced this year, and there should be more coming along the year. And we have also been working with Web3 projects and supporting our portfolio of investments in innovative ventures. So just a quick reminder, we have investments in companies, for example, like Silta Finance, Yellow Network, Green Gauge, SSV Network, GGS.io, and more. And so yes, advisory and working with our portfolio companies. And we also made recently a couple of announcements. So actually one yesterday, which is announcing working with a company called Liteflow, which is it's a Web3 and NFT technical developer. And earlier this morning, actually very fresh, we announced an investment in a company called Otomato, which is a Web3 automation protocol.
Could you tell us more about that deal with Otomato and what Otomato actually does?
The rationale behind Otomato is quite straightforward. If you're a user of blockchains every day, for example, to identify airdrops that you may qualify for, or if you are a daily trader in platforms that are called DeFi platforms, meaning decentralized finance platforms, you will very quickly see that each blockchain, each platform runs a bit in its own ecosystem. And it takes several steps to go from one to another or to start building what we call crypto strategies or Web3 strategies. And this gets even more complex if you're trying to do this across different blockchains. So Otomato basically can enable any on-chain actions. So again, possibly Web3 crypto trading actions. So for example, trading strategies, but without any coding skills. So in Web2, these type of platforms have been around for a while. There are some examples like Zapier, which is a $5 billion valuation company, or IFTTT. These companies have been running for a while in Web2, but in Web2, they're usually what we call productivity tools. So what they do is they help developers or companies run automated tasks that improve the productivity of these companies. But in the crypto space, obviously, as soon as you improve productivity, you also may actually improve your financial returns on these strategies. So it has a bit of a different different angle here. And we are quite happy that we came in very early stage in Otomato. And we believe it presents a great opportunity for us because it's a promising venture with quite a growth potential.
And you'll be buying $75,000 worth of future tokens in this early backers round. Is that correct?
Yes. So we have signed what we call a SAFT, a simple agreement for future tokens, for $75,000 of future tokens of the entity. And we also have an option for $150,000. That we can exercise over a period of months or before the token listing event. And we have been a bit creative this time in our deal. We even have a revenue share because we realize that sometimes, you know, the projects may delay for a number of reasons, sometimes the market sentiment and so forth, the actual issuance and listing of the tokens. So until then, we get a 7.5% revenue shares on the revenues of the platform.
Eddy, just given the revived interest in crypto this year, and we've had that Bitcoin ETF launching, we have the imminent launch perhaps of Ethereum ETFs. How do you see the year progressing for the company?
Well, for us, you know, what we have always been seeing is that as the crypto prices recover, the whole sector actually gets more attractive. In terms of, you know, more entrepreneurs come, more investors come, more users and traders come to crypto and blockchain. So definitely, Bitcoin ETFs is more of a, you know, kind of a macro type event. But for us, because we are focusing on startups, new ventures in this space, we always see a positive effect of these events. So for example, you know, one reason we are signing this MOU with Liteflow that we announced yesterday is because we foresee a large number of new ventures in the space, which start to attract users that may not be already in blockchain or that may not have any understanding, let's say, or deep understanding of blockchain or crypto or DeFi. And so we believe that we are on the brink of this kind of a mass adoption of these technologies. So with a company like Liteflow, we're going to finance, support, and empower a next generation of Web3 innovators. And the first step is a $1 million campaign for startups in this space. And also we'll be providing joint advisory services with Liteflow as well.
And Ben, following the big turnaround in your accounts last year, 2024 looking even better.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, with the continued growth in crypto prices, obviously, as Eddy was saying, you have this buoyant impact on sentiment. And, you know, yes, we've seen quite a lot of volatility of late. We actually talked to that in the accounts around the this sort of is a natural process that takes place after a halving event when miners have to, you know, readapt to a change to their profitability. But in the longer term, we see this trend continuing and look forward to the impact that has on all the various projects that we're supporting and the prospects of success.
Really look forward to discussing those with you as they occur. Thank you both very much for your conversation today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's Coinsilium Group CEO Eddy Travia and also Chief Financial Officer Ben Proffitt.